The often contentious debate about national education standards and testing kids has taken another twist in a state considered to be a leader in education reform. Massachusetts last week decided to reject the tests based on federal Common Core standards, tests that are still used in many other states. Instead, the state of Massachusetts will develop its own exams to measure student progress. New York Times reporter Kate Zernike is covering this story and joins me now. And Kate, what's great about you is that you wrote for the Boston Globe for years. Right. So you've been covering this for a long time.
Right.
What was the catalyst in Massachusetts that made the board say, hey, we want to create our own tests, which is kind of a hybrid thing, as opposed to sticking with the multi-state tests?
Well, I think it just came under a lot of political fire. And like other places in the country, the fire came not just from the left or the right, but from both sides, and really from in the middle, from a lot of parents who didn't feel like they had a really good argument on why we would want a national test which might allow us to compare to other states. So you had the right saying this is federal overreach. You had teachers' unions saying this is, you know, you're trying to be punitive, you're trying to tie this to teachers' evaluations. You had a lot of parents who were saying, well, what's the point of a national test anyway when we have one to begin with?
What's interesting about this also is there's a money component, as with most things, that the money that schools get is tied to test scores, correct? Right. How does this factor into this change?
Well, I mean, I guess, you know, Massachusetts has always had some accountability since the 1993 Education Reform Act. And that's what's interesting about this story, is that there was, for a long time, consensus in Massachusetts around the idea of having common standards and common high-stakes tests that kids had to pass for graduation. What the federal government did, and these standards weren't created by the federal government, they were created by the National Governors Association and other groups, but what the federal government did was say, we're going to fund these tests, and we want, you know, as a requirement of your federal funding, you're going to have to sign on to these standards and to these tests. And that's where people began to feel like this was punitive, this was overreach by the federal government.
People who are watching this might think, well, doesn't Massachusetts hasn't always done incredibly well on the testing? What's the need for a change?
Well, I think Massachusetts did, you're right, under its previous system of standards and tests, it rose to the top of the national rankings. But what they found was they were still having a lot of students who were showing up to college needing remedial education. And so they, you know, they had periodically updated their standards, and so they decided that they would join this National Governors Association effort to write national standards.
All right, so let's go dig down a little bit. This is actually going to be a hybrid test. Can you explain to our viewers what's going on here with this new Massachusetts test?
So there were two tests that were created under the Obama administration's Race to the Top program. They're PARC and the Smarter Balance test. Massachusetts was part of the PARC consortium of testing. Massachusetts will take some questions from the PARC exam, but it will continue to call, but the test will be created for Massachusetts. They feel it will, excuse me, be tied more to Massachusetts standards, and it will be called MCAS, which is the name of the test that Massachusetts, the state-specific test that Massachusetts has used for years.
What's the difference between the two? Like, what are they cherry-picking from one test group and another?
I think the argument for PARC was that it is tied to the Common Core standards, which are these national standards that we've had. The MCAS was tied to their old standards. I think a lot of people would say, well, we had these standards, what's wrong with them? The state felt that it was really upgrading the standards to tie them to the Common Core standards.
Let's pull back outside of Massachusetts. This influential state makes this big move. What does this mean in the bigger picture for Common Core?
Well, I think, you know, the next step in Massachusetts is going to be there's a ballot initiative or proposed ballot initiative that would repeal Common Core there, which would really be a statement. But I think what this means for the test is, the test is tied to the Common Core, is a lot of other states are going to look and say, wow, if Massachusetts, which was kind of this gold, you know, good housekeeping seal of approval, if they pull back, then what's the point of us doing this? Maybe this test isn't valid. I think what we're going to see is a lot of this accountability and testing devolve back to the states instead of at the national level, which is where it's been for the last 5 years.
Kate Zernike from the New York Times. Thanks so much.
Thanks.